everyone, and welcome to another video, and welcome to the Renault Megane RS. Here's the thing. What happens when you give a racing team a normal road-going car and ask them to tune it a little bit, just a little bit, but then no, the team decides, let's go bonkers, and here is the result. So this is the Renault Megane RS. The RS is the Renault Sport version of the I'm sorry about that. So Renault Sport division has put their hands basically on this and made this car into what animal that you see right now, or probably you haven't seen it yet but heard it right now. And okay, let's just calm things down a little bit. Let me put this in the comfort setting first. So yes, now to start off with, the reason why I started with the drive video was first that this is a driver focused and more essentially a driving focused car, so it is best to start off with the driving features first, because oh my god, I'm sorry I keep doing that, but I'll be doing a lot more in between, so just I apologize from before only. Anyways, let's start understanding this car and understand what is the fuss about this car. So in order to start, first thing, the engine of this car comes with a 1.8 liter turbocharged 4-cylinder inline engine. It's a tiny engine, but wait till you hear this. It produces 280 brake horsepower and 390 newton meters of torque, and you and 390 newton meters of torque comes at just 2400 rpm. It peaks at that point and then it just continues all the way till 4000, and every single bit of it you can feel it. And all of that power is being transferred into the front two wheels. So this car is a front wheel drive system. But more cleverly, there is also a six-speed automatic gearbox, which is the EDC gearbox. So that's an efficient dual clutch system. So if you know anything about dual clutch, they are pretty much the gearbox that you want in a performance car like this. So that is clubbed to the engine, and wow, that is just amazing. And the gears are always ready, so this is the best bit about the dual gear clutch gearbox, because the moment you want the next gear, the car is always ready with another set of clutch which has already engaged and anticipating what gear you will be in. So the gear shifts are pretty snappy, like the moment you step on the throttle and off you go. So there is also a flappy pedals that have been column mounted, but these pedals are actually a little bit shorter because my fingers actually don't reach, if you can make out from the video. So they are just at the tip, but they are more longer on the top side, so whenever you are turning it's easier to use, but then when you are going on a straight line it's just basically using a finger. Anyways, you will get a hang of it. But more importantly, hear those pops and the crackles, and hear that exhaust note which is so bassy, which is all grumpy, and this is all from a 1.8 liter engine. And imagine doing this, and this is just the stock exhaust, by the way. Just hear that. By the way, the paddle shifts are pretty snappy and they just lack a little bit of haptic feedback, but that is what I would say. There are some times when you wish the response was a little bit more from them, but it's all right anyways, because even the automatic gearbox in the race mode, or if you put it in the sport mode. But coming to the modes, by the way, so this car has like 5 different modes. So there is a comfort mode, neutral mode, there is sport mode, there is race mode, and then there is personal mode. So in the personal mode, you can just customize whatever you want to customize, the different aspects of the car, like the engine, the clutch and the gearbox, and the mood lightings, and how the throttle response, and all of the finer details that you want to, you can do all of that. But In my opinion, the sport and the race modes are pretty much the best things that you want. So let me put it in the race mode now. And the race mode just switches off the traction control. Now I am all by my own, and it improves the throttle response even more. So and even changes the dashboard, by the way, the screens on that. So it becomes all sporty rev counters, where you have the digital rev counters and the digital speedometer that is being displayed to you, along with the turbocharging pressures, the boost pressures that has been developing, the oil pressure and all. Coming to the suspension, the Renault has completely redesigned the suspensions on this car. So you get the strut settings in the front and the back, but what they have is something called as hydraulic suspension bump stop. So now what it does is essentially it's like a damper inside a damper. So there is another damper which has been put at the lower end of the struts in the front and the back. As a result of that, you get a very firm ride from the car, but that essentially means that the handling is improved and the steering response is just amazing. So the steering is pretty direct, and because of this, the suspension geometry, and also to do with the fact that the car itself comes with the Bridgestone Potenza S005, which are ultra high performance summer tires, and they just work in a way to give you this ride quality where you know how much grip levels you have at any point of time, and you are never going to go wrong. And this is not just even that. Another bit of clever trick that Renault Sport has added is the four-way steering system on this car, which they call it as the four control. Now you may wonder, why am I going in circles? So that is probably to show you that I am doing around 50 kilometers, or more so about that much, around that, or maybe less than that. So I am doing that much, and the steering system on this is so precise because of the fact that you have a four-wheel steering system, and that is when your rear wheels are also steering, but they have only 2.7 degrees of turn, but that is still essential to give you that handling performance that you want from the car. So everything is just adds up to make this as a race version of a normal road-going hatchback, and the reason hot hatch. So the steering wheel, how it works is, so when you are going on the road, when you are, say, going below 60 kilometers per hour but in a sport setting, so the wheels would turn in the opposite directions to give you the turning ability. But if you switch it to the race mode, then it goes under 100 kilometers when the rear tires would also turn in the opposite direction. But the moment you go about the speeds of 60 and 100 in their respective modes, then the wheels turn in the parallel, in essentially they turn in the same direction as the front wheels. That will help you changing lanes, or if you want to just have the straight line speeds, you can have that without having much of a drag. But the stiffer ride isn't an issue, because I mean, this is, you know, this is a racing version, and who cares? If you want the right quality with the softer settings, then there are lots of options that are available in the market. But this is a hardcore racing version. Coming to the braking department, Renault has put the Brembo brakes, and their performance is again phenomenal as expected, because anyway, there was no one around, so I could just brake test the car. So as you saw, it just grips them so well. So this is what you need from a performance car. So even that's a tick. There is much to do also in terms of the interiors and the exterior that has to do with the car itself, and not just the technological bit that goes into the car. So why don't you find out all of that while I just enjoy the ride. Let's start with the front. So in the front, you would find the C-shaped LED headlights with the DRLs, and also at the bottom, the RS, these These fog lights are RS inspired, so you would find the logo in here, and these are also LED, and this is just the plastic trim that you would find. There is also this F1 style blade that you see. This is actually working, and this actually helps in getting more grip. This acts like a front spoiler for the car to increase all the grip that you want. And there is this RS badging and also a big logo out here. There are also ways where the car will channel the air from inside and to the outside, where they would help in cooling the brake ducts, because the car has the performance brake pads and the Brembo brake calipers, and that is why they would need the cooling also extra. You get 19-inch diamond cut alloy rims, and inside you would find the big Brembo brakes, which gives you that performance and the braking power which you need from this car. And with that, you get these special tires, which are the Bridgestone Potenza S005, which are the ultra high performance summer tires. And look, these are like fake vents which actually do nothing, because I checked inside, there is nothing where the air would pass from here, so they're just there for the show. And you also get the Renault Sports badging, and these are power foldable mirrors with the blind spot warning system, and they come in this black color. But first, the main point that I forgot to discuss was, my God, look at the color of this car. It's the tonic orange. Now, I was so excited about this car that I forgot that I had to tell you about the orange color. Like, this is the most perfect color. Wherever you go, wherever you take this car, everyone sees and gives you a thumbs up, which is so cool. And continuing, you get the chrome surround and the four control system, which I discussed, where the four control means the four wheel steering which you get from the car. And these door handles, they are a keyless entry system, the smart keyless entry system. And there is a chrome strip on top, but on the sides there is an orange color to it. Now, the Megane RS is also wider than the standard Megane. So the Megane RS from the front is 60 millimeters wider, and at the rear is 45 millimeters wider. So you get a lot of track and the width of the car, which has been increased. And also the wheel hubs have been redesigned and made into aluminum, wherever there is the weight saving which was possible, they've done that. So they've saved about 1.8 kgs by making the hubs into aluminum. So 1.8 kgs each wheel, and you get the mat, and then it's 7.2 kilograms which they've saved eventually. So that's where you see all the small bits where they've done from the racing division, where they've helped save the weight on this car and increase the performance. In the back, you get these LED tail lights which are completely extended till the center. I really love these designs in the recent Renault, where they've extended the lights all the way till the center. They look so nice. Even the Megane badging that you get, and the RS logo. Now, RS logo is very much evident everywhere in the car, wherever you sit, to remind you that the Renault Sport has played a big part in designing this car, and that we'll see later on also inside in the interiors when you see that. And there is a camera which is mounted cleverly in the logo, Renault logo itself. If you notice, the rear view window is pretty small, and as a result, when you sit inside and when you look it from the rear glass, then the view is actually pretty small. In fact, there are actually headrests that will come also in the way, so the actual view that you get is pretty much like a middle of the lane from the rear view mirror. Now, if you look at the bottom, you would notice these vents which are just blocked. So these are just the plastic vents which are just there for the design, but they don't actually do or function for anything. But what functions is this diffuser, this white diffuser that you see at the bottom, and it actually works, and it helps in producing more downforce for the car. And in the center, you get this nicely put exhaust system. There are dual tips inside, but the whole exhaust system is made to look like a single one. Again, this is inspired from the racing division. And what is also inspired from the racing division is also these LED strip lights which you see at the top. And in terms of boot storage, you would find 384 liters of boot space. Now, there is a tire which is supposed to go inside, so you get a spare tire, but not a full size spare tire, but the normal tire, a little thinner one. So that tire goes into the bottom, but for some reason it has been tied down out here. So 384 liters of boot space, and The seats are collapsible. Now the seats are collapsible in a ratio of 1:3 to 2:3, which is how the Renault defines it. So in short, it is a 60:40 ratio. These seats are collapsible, and when you collapse these seats, there is enough of space to put big bags, two big bags. But this partial shelf is in between, and when you remove it, there is no place to put this somewhere. So you gotta put it in somewhere inside the middle row of the seats or at the bottom on the floor. But this is removable, and that is a good thing. And then as a result, you would get a big loading area, and also there is a fair bit of lip in the boot. Now jump inside, and the first thing that I mentioned before, which you would notice, are the Renault Sport badging everywhere, on the dashboard, on the steering wheel. Also when you open the door, on the frame, you would see the Renault Sport badging. And check out the key, which is so nice and so well made and thin. And continuing with the plastic quality, you get soft touch plastics on the dashboard and also on the door cards. This is a carbon fiber touch that they've given in the center, and also on the door cards you would see the carbon fiber inserts that they've put, which looks pretty nice. The steering wheel is actually a mixture of Alcantara and also the leather, but the leather is actually quite okay. It's actually the Napa leather that has been put along with the red stitching. But in the center you would find this center line, which has been provided. It is adjustable tilt and also the telescopic, and the paddle shifters are mounted on the column itself, and they are aluminium paddles. But the length of it is pretty weird, because they actually end where my fingers start. So in reality, there is only this much bit where I can just use the paddle shifts. Otherwise, when I'm turning, at that point of time I can use it. Now under that you would find another lever, actually, but this is just a fixed lever with buttons on it for your media controls. And there is a dial to control the channels or whatever source it is to change the music, which is pretty surprising to be putting it out there. But on the steering wheel itself, you would find on your right side there is the media controls, again mixed, where to answer the calls, or if you want to change the final settings from the dashboard, if you want to see any more details like your fuel consumption, the distance, the odometer and all of that, that you can change using a dedicated button. And on the left side you would see the cruise control, but the cruise control is half on the steering wheel and half of it is here. That is a speed limiter and the cruise control, with the button for which is mounted on the center console. There is also aluminium pedals that have been provided in the car. In the center you would find a 7-inch TFT screen, which is very, very nice. And then the whole layout is actually a little smaller, but then even the marking on the odometer is the speedometer is pretty weird. It starts from 30 50 70, ideally it starts from 20 40 and 60, but the Renault way is this way. Even the mood lightings would change the color based on the mode that you select. There is also a personal mode where you can customize everything: what gearbox you want, what engine type you want, what is the exhaust note that you want, what is the lights that you want, what is the dial that you want. So all of that also can be customized individually. Coming to the center, you would see an 8.7-inch touch screen, which is pretty wide in terms of feature, but it's pretty simple and pretty flatly merged into the dashboard. And this, the screen is pretty varied, where it will show you also your RS monitor. The RS monitor is something, when you put your car in sport mode or the race mode, it will tell you how much is the angle, the wheels that are turning, and also how much is the power from the engine and all of that, and pretty much every single detail that you want to see: the oil temperature, the intake temperature of the air and everything. And there is also the navigation system that you would find. There is also the different modes that you can see it on the screen. There are also different settings that you can change from inside the system. Now in terms of connectivity, you would get Bluetooth and auxiliary, and that is pretty much about it, and also USB. So there are two USB ports provided that are also for the charging, and also there is 120 watt power socket here in the front and 120 watt power socket in the back that has been provided for the charging. Now coming to the AC control, the AC controls are a little weird. So in order to control the AC, it's from the touchscreen itself, but the finer settings, like if you want to put it in auto or the recirculation, that has been provided out here, or the dials have been given to change the temperature. It's a dual climate control system. So to entertain you, This car has 9 speaker Bose music system and they sound incredible. In terms of storage feature, you can put 1 liter of bottle in the door cards and some more stuff in the side, and it's also lined with the carpet lining inside at the bottom. And there is one small storage out here where you can put your phone, and also there are 2 cup holders. The cup holders are actually pretty shallow, so whenever you put, the chances of it spill, your drink spilling are on the higher side. And there is a glove box, and also there is a storage in the center which is pretty small again. Now the seats come with a mixture of Alcantara and the Napa leather, and they come with this RS inscription and also this thick shoulder at the side, so side wall on the seat, so that whenever you're going on the track day, these will give you pretty nice support. But they are on the harder side, let me be very honest, but they are super comfortable and they give you ample of support around your body. So, and they are, when you are sitting inside, you are pretty much tucked in into the seat. These seats are manually adjustable, and this is where Renault has also saved quite a bit of weight by going manual. So these seats are 6-way adjustable. This car comes with a normal sunroof which can be opened quite a way till halfway of the car, and there is a dial to open the sunroof, which is pretty weird. Usually you have a button. In the back, I'm afraid to report, things are a little cramped. So if you can see, these seats are almost in my driving position, which is fairly behind, and there is not much of leg room out here, although these seats are curved, but yet there is just a little bit of a gap, but there is enough of headroom. And there is again this handrest and the AC controls which you get in the back. So this is actually protruding quite a way, quite a bit into the third seat, and when I show you, this is actually in my way, so there are chances of you hitting this a lot of times, and that is a reason why things won't be comfortable if you are the third person sitting out here. But if you sit in the normal seats, these are again like the bucket seats, and also they have this Napa leather and the mixture of Alcantara along with the red stitching. In the center, you would find this handrest and along with the 2 cup holders, and also again these are not too shallow, so again you may sort of end up spilling the drink. But if you see, the door cards are made out of plastic compared to the ones in the front, which were made like half into soft touch plastics where you touch on the top, but these are completely made into plastic, and there is just a little bit of carbon fiber insert that they put along with the mood lighting. In terms of safety departments, you get 6 airbags, 2 in the front, 2 in the side, and 2 curtain airbags. You get child ISOFIX mounting points, you get tire pressure monitoring system, there is also ABS parking sensors, and also there is a single camera system. The camera is put on the screen itself, where it shows you a mixture of parking sensors and the camera system that has been put out here in the screen, so that the camera quality is all right. I mean, anyways, I just don't want to complain, because there is nothing to complain about all of those things, because again, understand, this is a performance car. I'm not saying buy this car because this is the best car. No, I am just saying that this is one of the best car, and why not? Because this is such a practical car. It's a small car. You can take it anywhere. You can also take it onto a track day without doing any special modifications. All you have to do is just change the race mode, and then you are onto the track day, and then you can have some fun and come back. And to be honest, the pricing is also pretty average. I mean, the basic starts from the 119,000 and goes all the way up to 136,000 as you spec this car, but it's still all right compared to what performance you get and what is the engineering. And especially you are a nerd, then this is a car that fits perfectly for you. Anyways, give it a thumbs up if you like this video, and if you want to subscribe to my channel, click here, and if you want to watch more videos, then click here. Anyways, I'm off and I am gonna enjoy some more ride in this car.